We have the following task given. Write down context-free grammar rules with feature structures as non-terminals that denote the structure of a sentence that consists of NP and VP. So what does it mean? Maybe you remember those phrase structure rules that look something like this. You have a sentence or S that expands to a nominal phrase and a verbal phrase. And you have the NP that expands to a determiner and a noun and a verbal phrase that consists of a verb and another nominal phrase. So, and now we are going to create rules similar to that one, but instead of using those non-terminals, we will have feature structures. And I hope you saw my other videos about feature structures, so you know what they mean and how they work. So we will create those three rules as feature structures. Let's start with the first one. It will look something like this. So it's a little bit similar to that one. So this one is for the sentence. I now write into that what we already know. So I know that this feature structure will have the category sentence. And then I know that this one will have the category NP. And this one will have the category VP. So that's easy at the first. The first step is easy, I think. The others will be similar to that one. So I will have one rule of category NP. That's for the second rule. NP consists of a determiner and a noun. And then for the third rule, we know that this one will be like here, the VP. And it will consist of something of category verb and something of category NP. So now we can create sentences that are rubbish, and we have to make sure that we can only the task asks us that the rule shall only be able to generate well-formed sentences like a man loves all women or all women love a man and so on. And yeah. When I assume I don't know anything, I will just have a look at the example sentence and then see what are the differences in here. So here is a man loves and here is all women love. So that's a difference. Now that I will check what are the properties of all those words, and maybe in this case I start with the numerus. So I see all is of numerus, it's plural, women are also plural, love, in this case, well, you know, I could say I love or you love, but in this example, we only have third person, so I don't need to care about the other cases. In this case, love can only be plural. Then we have a and men, and those both are singular. So that means somehow I may have to make sure that in a nominal phrase, the both parts have the same numerus, and then I will have to take care of that the numerus, if the nominal phrase has the same as the verb. So let's start with the easy case in a nominal phrase. So this one and this one, they correspond to a nominal phrase. So, and I know that they should have the same numerals. So what I now am doing is Well, I could create two rules. I could create one rule that says this one has to be singular and this one has to be singular. And I can also create a second rule saying this one is plural and this one is plural. But I can merge them to only one rule by using a pointer. So I'm saying I don't care what the numerus actual is, but I put a pointer in here. And the numerus here has to be the same as this one. And now this can create me all the rules where, well, I can now only create all women or a man, but I cannot create a woman. It would be wrong and I cannot create this one anymore. So now let's have a look at the sentence. If we remember the whole sentence, it looks something like this. So you have the sentence consists of NP and VP. And the NP consists of the determiner and the noun, and the VP of a verb and the NP. And now what our problem is that we want that this nominal phrase, so let's take another color, let's take this one. We want to make the numerus that's the same in this one also is the same as in this verb. So what we have to do is we need the same numerus to be passed to that one and also in that one. So that we can pass, that they can, we can make sure that they have the same numerus. So what we are doing now is, we know, as you can see in the sentence, that NP and VP, they must be the same, something like a same numerus. So I go to this one and I say, well, whatever the numerus is in that NP, I can use the same pointer because it's the same pointer of an the same number for a pointer because it's only valid in one rule. I have to say that something, some numerus has to be the same in those NP and in those VP. Now I can go to the VP, and here if you imagine that this whatever is put in here, it is passed down to that one. So I will get a numerus here. And then I say I want that the verb also has the same numerus. So now it's passed down to the verb and I have exactly what I want. And this one I will not specify it for that, so it can be any numerus. But now there's another problem left. Now I pass in the numerus here. And then I need to take it here and then also pass it down to whatever is here. Now they are in a different color, but they are the same number, so they are the same. And that's then, now I have my grammar with feature structures as non-terminals.